New at 6:30 tonight, Nevada could be looking at a billion-dollar payday.
That's according to two Las Vegas communication experts who are now suing several travel companies, claiming they didn't pay enough hotel taxes to the state. The suit claims when these companies don't pay, it comes out of your pocket.
Yeah, News 3's Maria Thompson uncovers the significance of this potential payout.
We've all used a travel company at one point or another to help with our vacation planning. We're talking about websites like Expedia, Priceline, TripAdvisor, Booking.com. Now those companies and several more could pay the state of Nevada a lot of money because of a lawsuit.
I use Booking.com because it's relatively easy.
We did Priceline.
Yeah, we usually buy Priceline, Expedia, or Booking.com.
Walk down the Strip or Fremont Street for just a few minutes, and you'll meet a handful of tourists and locals who rely on websites like Expedia and Travelocity to secure their vacation hotel rooms.
That's where the deals are.
Yeah, it's a lot less stressful.
Booking from your house is probably just easier.
But a lawsuit now making its way through the courts, claiming those companies aren't paying what they owe each time a room is booked in Nevada.
They have seen this deficiency for a long period of time, and they felt that it was their duty to bring it forward on behalf of the state.
That's attorney Michael Cristalli. He's part of a team that represents communication executives Sig Rogich and Mark Fierro. They are suing more than a dozen online travel companies on behalf of the state of Nevada. The lawsuit claims these companies did not pay their full share of what's called the transient lodging tax required by state law.
Whatever they sold the room for to the customer, that's what the tax liability is against.
In other words, according to the suit, state law provides that if the online travel company sells a room for $150 to a guest, that company must pay taxes on the full $150.
These are damages. This is money that was owed to the state. And in those years that this money was not paid, that money did historically come out of the taxpayer's pocket.
Rogich and Fierro claim the damages could exceed $1 billion. Most of it would be paid out to the state. Room taxes funnel money to the Clark County School District, Las Vegas tourism agencies, and other public funds.
That's a lot of money. That's a lot of policemen. That's a lot of schools. That's a lot of teachers. That's a lot of health care. It's a lot of money.
Rogich and Fierro first filed this suit in 2020 in the height of the COVID pandemic and statewide economic challenges.
When we saw the pandemic arrive and the kind of damage that we could anticipate would be done to our economy, I think people got a little bit more sensitive, and certainly we did, are the people of the state of Nevada receiving all that they're entitled to?
Within the last month, a judge recently denied a motion to reconsider dismissal. That means the case moves forward, barring state Supreme Court intervention.
The one thing that it'll be interesting to see how these companies operated when they first came into the state with the hotels, and you know how they're operating currently or within the last several years, and how that's changed.
I've reached out to every travel company listed on the lawsuit asking for a comment. None replied, but they did petition to the Nevada Supreme Court. They said the case should be thrown out because Clark County is a party in a separate suit for the same allegations. We'll keep you updated on that outcome. Reporting in the studio, Maria Thompson.